a standard. Well, shown here, this is the definition from CN. They talk about it being a technical document that is rules, guidance, definitions, but it's really important that it's consensus built and it's repeatable. Mm-hmm. What they say is bringing all of these parties that are interested in that same goal together. And one of the outcomes is lower transaction costs. There are many other important outcomes of having standards. John, in your work, I'm sure that talking the same language when it comes to contracting is a big thing. Any other thoughts as we standardize? Why are standards important for the USIBD?
Well, standards are important not just for USIBD, but just for people in general, I think, because it really helps build efficiencies in workflows. It helps create an understanding that people know what to expect.
Absolutely, yep. And standardizing, having common language, the efficiencies, it means that people can actually talk and understand rather than spend time interpreting. Really important. Couple of examples.
I think that there's a measurable factor too. To compare one project to another, you really have to keep what you can consistent. Every project is unique, but you can't really compare the success between a project and your processes unless you follow the same format.
Metrics. Yeah, absolutely. Here and here, they talk about a 3-year cycle going from proposal through accepting that it should be created, a draft of it, going through the inquiry, adoption, a vote, publication, users, feedback, the whole cycle. John, can you relate to that?
Yes, I can. And it's a painful process and it takes far too long.
And what I didn't have the perfect quote, but seeing the Google mentions of the word standard over time, I expected that to be increasing rapidly. But it looks like for the last 50 odd years, it's been plateauing, or 70 years, it's been plateauing. Yeah. I don't know whether we can make any sense of that, whether it's just something that I found interesting and nobody else does. There's my interesting statistic. So what do customers say about the standards?
Yeah, some find them very complex, difficult to understand. There's many of them out there. So which ones are we going to use to begin with? And
this is actually a quote, and we have three quotes, and the names have been removed just because I don't think that people want these quotes to be labeled that they are their own quotes. But there are a lot of people. We went through a 6-month just fact-finding study going around the world and finding out what people had challenges with when it comes to standards. And this was one. Another saying sometimes they're too detailed in some areas, non-existent in other areas, and not practical for some of their real projects. But these were constructive criticism because it was people that wanted to solve these problems. And then also standards sometimes feel too fixed, not flexible for them, and they had to implement by filling in the gaps. I've kind of ad-libbed that, but the quote's on there. And really that wall between standards teams that are really trying to create something valuable for end users and the end users, we seem to find time and time again. So what does the customer do? Like when that situation happens, what does that customer of the standard then do?
Good question. So basically, you know, the easiest thing to do is either start with the template and then start creating their own, or starting from scratch, just based off of their own goals and opinions. So really we end up with more and more standards out there. And sometimes you see others just huddle up and create their own user group and go off on their own standards. But for the most part, you know, why is that? Why did they do that?
why use one standard when 5 will do? I love this cartoon because it happens time and time again where there is good intent, but we end up creating more and more standards.
We hear it all the time where we get people saying that, oh, well, I started with this standard and over the years, it's just kind of become our own company thing. So, you know, having to go back and update based off of other standards bodies has been more difficult because you kind of have to, you don't know what has worked and what hasn't because it's already veered off in its own direction over time.
So why didn't the customer instead provide their feedback? Why did they go off and create their own? What was the cause of that? John, do you Do you have experience of that?
Well, I suspect that it's not very easy for them to provide feedback. And even if they are able to get the feedback to the right people, the process of updating the standards is typically such a slow one that they don't have time to wait for that process to play out. They just need to get in, get their work done. And I think they're doing whatever they need to do to advance that.
Yeah, everyone has a project to do. Yeah, right. Absolutely. And so we see these challenges that it's, as I think you were talking about, that it's a disconnected feedback loop and slow to react, sometimes taking years, counting in years to get something included in a standard, does become challenging. And therefore, when you've got project timing and important project deliveries and goals to achieve, and that can be a difficult thing. We also see that some of the really great intent from the volunteers that are leading these charges have day jobs. They've got their own work to contend with and other deadlines, not just to update standards. So it really is a challenge. And that disconnect creates a blocker we've seen for that feedback to be even provided. So instead of even providing or wanting to provide the feedback, we've seen people go off and create their own. And we also see, so when we see this happen, it's usually because people have their own use case that's specific, maybe slightly different from the intended use case. And sometimes the pace of their change is radically different. You know, we have BIM experts now that they're creating new tools and new ways of doing things that might not be akin to the standards that have been available in the past.
It's just different goals from different companies.
So yeah, we have different universities that have adopted BIM and they have their own standards. And we hail those universities because they've done a great job. It's better to have a standard than not to have a standard. But having different standards for every single university that you work with, it is not as productive for the teams delivering for the customer of the standard as it could be. We have consultants that are helping teams create standards and specifications in lots of different ways and lots of different groups, user groups around the world for different products as well. Sometimes standards could be specific for a product, then handover. What is handed over at the end of the day? That ties in very well with John on the accuracy side of things. When people are specifying, it's not just about what content is involved, but there's a whole set of layers of how detailed, how developed, how accurate that needs to be. So it can be quite complex, the different reasons and purposes and the pace at which people need that to be updated.
Right.